y'all. It's me, Nikki, Taurean Goddess, coming in with a real quick message. Y'all already know what I'm coming to do. I'm coming to bring the actual factuals, get you hip to what you hip to, or hip you on to what may be hidden. Ain't nothing but love here. I want everybody to know that there are some treatments that are being noticed for your health. It is working. Whatever it is that you're doing and you're ingesting, what you're eating, your habits that you've changed, it is a positive result, period, point blank. So what I'm hearing is something about your kingdom spouse, your God-ordained spouse. Everybody wants this person. Do you hear me? I'm talking about everybody wants this person. But anybody who approaches this man or this woman, you know, who want to be in a relationship, start talking to them, you know, move the relationship from friend zone and to a different relationship status, they kind of go off on them. They haven't told them that they know who their God-ordained spouse is. Do you know who Most High chose for you? Because this person is now recognizing, analyzing, and realizing is what I'm hearing. And they kind of pissed off. They feel like you're being disrespected when people are, you know, flirting with them, trying to take them out on dates and whatnot. This person is suffering from some mental health issues, some depression, some anxiety. What I'm hearing is that you know this person, you've dated this person, you've been in a relationship with this person. I don't know if you two are together, and this is the reason why. They be like, hold up, why are you so disrespectful? This is where I cut it at. Why are you so disrespectful? You know who the love of my life is. Mm-hmm. But it's a lot going on between the two of you, and it has a lot to do with ego. It has a lot to do with, you know, people, places, and things, mainly people. There really has been a lot of interruptions in your love story is what I'm hearing. And look at whatever, I cut it again. Don't quit, though. Don't quit. This union, you're not on the same page present day. It's been a lot of people who was not so happy for y'all is what I'm hearing. And they did, you know, you gotta protect what you want and what you love, and sometimes you gotta shield it from family, friends, acquaintances, you know, your business, your job. You know, you have to draw a line and a sand. I heard something about a lane as well. Somebody is picking a lane. Mm-hmm. Look at this here, 222. 222, that sure enough is a twin flame soulmate number. And it's also a sign, a synchronicity for you to let you know that your life is changing and it's going in the direction of how you already agreed for it to go. You know, it's now everything is falling in place. Everything is falling in place right now. Life is starting to balance out, but it's just one more balancing act is what I'm hearing. One more balancing act. That goes with saying, don't nobody matter right now at this stage of the game besides you and your person. Your twin flame been trying to send you a message too. You've been doing a lot of work on yourself. I feel like you've been really taking some accountability about, you know, some flaws in your character. Strengthening those attributes that you know are a blessing is what I'm hearing. A blessing to you, a blessing to your relationship. Missy Chapman. Sexual rendezvous. Somebody is mad about, you know, y'all was on a break. Y'all on a break. Separation. Somebody dip their toes into some lakes. Dip their toes into some lakes. But you know, it was due to the lack of communication, is what I'm hearing. Reciprocity, no love being shown. And somebody felt as though they had to make some sacrifices in order to make themselves feel good. You know, in this, whoever this person is that they're with, it's a kismet relationship, and it was faded. It was faded. It was also a part of y'all blueprint. Somebody had to go down a shit brick road to recognize, analyze, and realize that this is not the part of their destiny that was chosen. This is a karmic relationship, although it could be, you know, very, it's like it's a bunch of lust is what I'm hearing. A bunch of lust. Libra. Now the tables are turning. The tables have turned. Somebody wants to be faithful now. They want to be faithful, and I'm hearing it is they're down on their luck. Somebody may have lost their job. However, you are full-time employed. Clientele. I'm hearing something about consumer reports. Somebody has been consumed in this energy with this kismet relationship, but they have been seeking a way out. Somebody got into a relationship with somebody that they just met, you know, I don't know how long ago, but they met them and the relationship started quick. But this person is not happy. They're not happy. Well, they're not happy. And, you know, it's some side effects to this relationship as well. There's a lot of side effects to this relationship. They're depressed. And they really haven't spoken up for themselves. They feel like they're cheating on you. You may not even know that they're in this relationship, or you could know. They're in a relationship with a stripper. These cards coming back out, east side. This may have something to do with the silent treatment. Yep. This person has been giving you the silent treatment, but they really want to talk to you. They do. They want to talk to you. They feel some type of way. They feel like they're experiencing a lot of karma, a lot of bad karma, you know, for the way that they treated you. Look at this shit here. They feel like because of the way that they treated you, that nothing is working. Most definitely nothing is working in this relationship on their end, from their view. Their perception has changed. They changed in their mind. They like, what the fuck have I done type energy. You on their mind 24/7. They almost slipped up and said your name during sex. Yes, this person is still having sex within this relationship. But even that is depleting their energy. That has them, I heard something about a cream pie. Regardless of, you know, orgasms, you know, how good the sex is, they still feel you. I don't know how you taking this message. You they flavor. You they flavor of the month. They won't even have oral sex with this person, is what I'm hearing. this person is just having sex in this relationship just to, you know, just to feel as though that they're accomplishing something without you. You may already know about this person being, you know, something like a hoe type. Hoe type meaning not like they soft, but, you know, they fucking everything that moves prior to you, probably with you as well. I just heard you all have been through so many ups and downs that it don't make no damn sense. Somebody let go. They released this twin flame. They released this twin flame. No, they're not a karmic twin flame. This person came into your life at the divine appointed time, and then they dipped off because they were scared. They were scared of love. They were scared of openly committing to you. Then you know it was who was in their ear. And who was in your ear? Look at this here. Look at this here. A lot of the sex that they have, I'm hearing, is just this. Just this. They feel like they ain't cheating because they're getting head, y'all. And what did I say earlier? They're going through a lot of karma. I don't know how your relationship ended, but I'm hearing as though, like, you were innocent. I'm hearing you were innocent. They're waving a white flag. They're giving up. They're surrendering. They're going to come to you like they're innocent, but they're going to be filled with peace. They're going to be filled with peace, a peaceful energy. And they're going to keep this peaceful energy and this white light around them. They feel like they're being spiritually guided to you. No matter what it is that they do, all the clues, all the synchronicities, all the intuitive nudges, it always lead back to you. So they've been praying for a breakthrough. They've been praying for a breakthrough, period. They made some promises to you that they felt as though that they broke. They're ready to hold up their end of the bargain. Because this is how they feel. You two were meant to be together, period. That's your message. See you.